thank you for joining us for another episode of So You Want to Be an AI Superstar. I'm your host, Dolly Sue, and I'm excited to have you all here today. In this episode, we're tackling all things email with Copilot and Outlook, because mastering your inbox is a superpower we all could use. And joining me today is Ryan Day, our Outlook marketing lead, who's going to help us get closer to that elusive inbox zero dream we've all been chasing.
I'm honored to be here today with the team, representing the full Outlook team, showing you how to get the best out of Outlook with Copilot. We're going to be showing you a few things today. Specifically, one, how you can write better emails with the help of Copilot. Two, how we can sift through our inbox and really distill and summarize the best things in our email with Outlook. Three, how Outlook can coach you to ensure the mails that you write are better and land the way you want them to on your intended audience. And then four, we have some really fun stuff that I'm excited to show you with theming.
Ryan, will you kick us off with the lay of the land? Where can you access Outlook? Where do you find Copilot in Outlook? What if someone out there might still have a hotmail.com account asking for a friend?
We love hotmail.com. Hotmail is actually what became Outlook. It's fantastic to use. A lot of our users still use the Hotmail account, and that will work great. Just as a live account or an Outlook.com account. And it's important to remember, Outlook is for all emails. So no matter if you have a Gmail account, a Yahoo account, an iCloud account, even AOL, it's all at home across all the family of Outlook apps. For me, I personally like that. I have multiple accounts. I know a lot of other people do too. And I love to use Outlook on mobile and on the desktop to go through all those accounts in one place. It's a really great way for me to, not only when I'm at work, but when I'm on the go, triage and make sure I'm getting all I can from all those various accounts.
Okay, great. I'm glad we cleared that up about Hotmail. I'll let my friend know. Okay, so good to know. Like, so we can access it on the browser, we can access it mobile, on the go. Great that we have that accessibility. Where do we see this action? What are we starting with?
All right, let me pull it up. So important to say, today I'm going to be showing everybody Outlook in the Outlook.com experience. But like Dolly said, we can see Outlook in a variety of other places, be it Windows desktop, where it comes preloaded with Windows 11, Mac, iOS, and Android. It's in a wealth of places. But here you see our beautiful Outlook.com experience on the web.
Awesome. Okay.
All right.
So you're logged in. You're in your personal account. Not so personal. Right.
This is not my person. This is one of our friends named Casper, who does not really exist, but he gets a lot of work in. Gets a lot of email too.
A very friendly guy. Okay, so how do we get to Copilot in Outlook?
Perfect. So obviously there's a lot you can do with Outlook, and it's very powerful. As you can see up here on the very top right, if you look in the corner, we have the Copilot button. Where it can just help you with drafting a new email and settings. And there's a variety of other ways we can get into Copilot from here. Should we get started, Dolly?
Yep, let's do it.
Perfect. So I'm going to just hit draft up here, draft a new email. And then as you can see, immediately it opens up a new email prompt, and you can see Copilot popping up here, prompting you, hey, try an option below. We can write short and friendly messages, request information, etc. So we're already trying to help with what I call the cold start problem, helping people use Copilot in Outlook to write messages. So, you know, Dolly, we have kids around the same age, and I love when we take them to the park. So hold on, let me do this. And apologies, everybody, as you have to see me type. I did take typing lessons growing up, so hopefully seventh grade paid off. Invite Dolly and her son to the park with my boys. They love on a splash pad, and then we can maybe. Say typos. If we can do this on Thursday next week. All right. So I've just typed
to fix that typo there.
Now let's see. Let's go click generate right here, friend. Now Copilot's going in the background, taking the prompt that I wrote and writing a great email. So as you can see, really, really well done. Hi, Dolly. Hope your son are doing well. I wanted to reach out and see if you'd be interested in joining my boys and I. I'm not going to read the rest of the mail, but you can see from that prompt, we're able to build it out. Now, important few important things to know. One, Outlook's never going to send an email for you or write an email for you unless you direct it to. In addition, it's not going to keep the message that's written without your guidance. It's really important for us that the user, that you feel that you're in control of your messaging and we're not doing things necessarily without your permission. As you can see also, there's a variety of things I can do. I can ask Copilot to retry. I can ask them to make the message shorter, make it longer, or even change the tone. I love changing the tone, and as you can see, there's a few different ways you can do it. You can be direct, casual, formal, and one of them that I love is like a poem. So I'm going to click on like a poem, and let's see what Copilot comes up with. So now it's taking what it's already written and turning into a fun little poem. Hi, doll. I hope you and your son are well. Would you join the boys and me a Friday next Thursday? So this is a great way to bring fun and joy and a little bit of mischief to it. So what I could say here is keep it, then I could add Dolly's email, add a quick subject line, and hit send.
I love it. That was so easy. I just got an example from one of my friends. She's applying to a job that she saw online. It's a rough market out there. She's reaching out to hiring managers and recruiters. Yeah. She's having that cold start problem with how do I start an email reaching out to these folks? Can we help with a more formal email like that too?
Absolutely. So let me show you. So last time I started an email, I clicked on this Copilot button on the top right. It said draft. But there's another way we can get to Copilot very quickly. And that is simply just by hitting the new mail tab. So I'm going to hit the new mail tab. And again, draft Copilot comes up here as well. If I click on the icon, I can do exactly what I wanted to say. So Dolly, what kind of job is your friend applying for?
A marketing manager.
Okay. Let's see. Type. An email.
And this is great. Right. Previously, so she was typing into copilot.microsoft.com, just pasting it in, but it's great that we can do it natively within Outlook as well.
That's exactly right. I think a lot of people think you have to go to copilot.microsoft.com or Microsoft Word and write an email there and then copy and paste it. If you want to write an email, Outlook is the best place for you to write that email. And we've made sure that all the intelligence that you've seen those other Copilot places are right here in Outlook, and that is across desktop, the browser like I'm in now, or on iOS or Android. So I'm going to click generate, and what this is going to do is basically create an email for your friend for that marketing manager position. Now, of course, we can make it shorter, we can make it longer, we can change the tone just like we did in the past. Now, it's important to say, again, Copilot hasn't put this into the email yet. You still have to click on keep it, and then the email is actually written for you and placed into the mail. And of course, we can go through, we can highlight things, we can even change certain lines if we want to. Like, hey, let's auto rewrite this line, and it can rewrite those sentences for you as well. So there's tons of ways that not only will it help you start the email, but help you continue to edit the email and give you ideas to make it exactly what you want it to be. And then obviously you put the to line, add a subject, click and send.
I love it because we're always sending, you know, various emails to various audiences. To our friends, we want a different tone. To a hiring manager, we want a different tone. So good to know that Copilot can handle all of that.
Can I show you a few more things, friend?
Yeah, please.
All right. One of the things, I'm a dad. I have a job. I'm on the go. I got two young boys, 12 and 10. I'm on mobile a lot. But as we know, jobs and life doesn't wait for anybody. Right. So I love this next feature, which is called Summarize. In our example right here, Casper and his friends Amanda and Eugenia are planning a trip. So I'm going to click on this camping trip email thread that they have. And as you can see, we have three emails about a camping trip that they are planning. Casper kicked it off and then it's gone a little bit. We got a beautiful photo here of Amanda's dog. So if you're on the go, especially if anyone's had to suffer through a family text chain before, sometimes you just really want to get the gist of what is going on. So what we have here is Summary by Copilot. If I click on Summary by Copilot, it's going to read the entire email thread and tell me exactly the details I need to know about this thread. So Summary is telling me You suggested planning the camping trip in the middle of August. You said go to Pixaw. Eugenia agreed and gave me a list of tons of detailed packing things we need for the trip. And then Amanda also said she would love to go on the trip, but she has some dietary issues and she wants to bring the dog Patches. All right. Now, this is a great way to get the gist, but of course we still have to reply and keep the thread going. Can I show you one more fun thing, Dolly?
Yes, because these threads are exactly what clogs up my inbox, where it just gets too lengthy and I just freeze out.
As we say in the South, ain't no one got time for that. So let me do something really quick. I'm going to reply all here. Now, we're going to write a really kind of crude email back to Amanda. Okay, so it's going to be, Amanda, do you have to bring the dog? I worry about him getting lost. Also, that is a lot of extra food. Can you tough it out? Again, not a nice email. This
not
is not
so
going to come.
Not so friendly, Casper.
Not so friendly. Casper's not the friendly ghost right now at all, right? But what we can do is we can, go up to Copilot and say, hey, Copilot, can you give me some coaching on this email? And this is really important when we're writing important emails to our friends, our families, a doctor, a teacher, who knows? You really want to make sure you're putting your best foot forward. Obviously, Casper is not putting his best foot forward here, but we're going to help him. Copilot's going to help him a little bit get better on that. So we're going to click coaching. Now, what coaching's doing, it's scanning the email that I just wrote back, reviewing it for tone, clarity, and also reader sentiment. As you can see, Copilot is saying, no, 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 you don't want to send the email the way it is right now. It's saying, hey, why don't you give some gentle encouragement to Amanda, right? You may want to consider changing a different greeting. You may want to rephrase some of your concerns and making sure it lands on her the right way. It also is giving us coaching on reader sentiment, saying, hey, acknowledge that Amanda has attachment with her dog. Be more supportive and invite her input by saying, let me know your thoughts. And then clarity, it's saying, hey, you may want to consider the trip, like just be a little clear in this email. And as Casper has taken a breath, he's calmed down a little bit. He's like, all right, let's apply all these suggestions. So if I go down to coach, let's apply all these suggestions to my nasty mail. It's going to apply those suggestions to the email.
Yeah, absolutely. I love this. I feel like we could all use a partner or coach to keep us from sending some of those emails that we might regret. And I like that it teaches you along the way, like what exactly is being called out and a lot more information.
Absolutely. Okay. Absolutely.
So we can't end this session without talking about how pretty your Outlook is. What is this mean? How can I get all of this prettiness?
You're so kind. Well, I will show you. This is called theming, as you might have seen at the beginning of this session. Theming is one of the ways that we're trying to make Outlook more personable for everybody and allow everybody to basically create their own Outlook. So let me go ahead and do this for you. In order to get a theme, and if you have a Copilot subscription, you can access themes. What you need to do is go up here on the toolbar and click View. And then just right below there, View Settings. When you click on View Settings, it's going to bring up the settings page. You want to click on this little gear icon called General. After that, you click on Appearance. All right. So again, View Settings, General Appearance. When you do that, it brings up a variety of different themes we have within Outlook, ways you can personalize it. We have modern themes. We have different colors. But we also have themes by Copilot, which I love. What this does, it allows you to create a custom theme that is bespoke to you, to your style, and the way you want it. With custom theming, we can create a theme right now based off of either locations or weather. If you said, hey, Copilot, you can know where I am. We're going to go ahead and create a location. Dolly, we have over 100 locations here to choose from, as well as local where I am in Raleigh, North Carolina. Where would you like to pick, friend?
Let's choose Dublin.
All right, we'll go back up. Let's go to Dublin.
Nice and rainy for us, probably.
Dublin. All right. Now we can do different styles, too. I was just showing a cartoon style, but we can do realistic, oil painting, or a cartoon. What would you like?
Ooh, let's do realistic. See how realistic. Real we can go.
Great. And then there's different ways you can refresh. Let's just go refresh every month. Important to note that when you create a custom theme within Copilot, it will take up a credit. But again, the team's done an amazing job creating these amazing visuals for us here, and I've never had an image created for me that I didn't love. So we're going to click on create right here. It's going to take a few minutes.
And you hit refreshes every month, so it'll stick with Dublin and realistic. Sorry, cut you off there, but it'll be Dublin realistic every month. It'll be a different scene. Is that right?
Correct.
Okay. So if you want to come back in here, choose a different city, you can come back in here, follow the same steps.
So as you can see in this beautiful realistic theme, it's created this beautiful, lush, green cityscape of Dublin. So we can go in and apply it, and then it may be a little bit hard to see in emails, but it's going to come up directly behind in the background of the email. And so now, whenever I log into this email or into my email, Casper's email, it's going to show this rich, beautiful scene behind the scenes.
Awesome. And we all spend so much time in email, so it's really nice to have a beautiful scene while we're crafting those or having Copilot help draft those emails as well.
Absolutely. Absolutely. We're just going to wait for this little bit. Here we go. So there, and as you can see, the background has changed and now it shows Dublin in the background.
Thank you so much for your time and demoing.
Yeah. So again, just to recap, we showed you four things today, Copilot and Outlook. We showed you Copilot drafts, helping you get over that cold start problem and draft those great emails. We showed you Copilot Summarize, helping you summarize those long email threads, distilling down exactly what you need in that email, and then making sure you can make the right decisions and can do it quickly. We also have Coach, like we saw with Casper. We don't want to send those nasty emails. So what Coach helps you do is make sure you're putting your best foot forward. It's also great if you're writing something super professional and you still want the reassurance that you're putting your best foot forward, use Coach. I use it all the time to make sure my emails are landing in the right way. And then we showed you themes, which is just another way for us to make email more fun, more personal, and more for you.
Thank you, Ryan. That was a great wrap up.